Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study about the population composition. Population composition means the country in which there are various type of or structure of people, structure of population. For example, people belong to certain ages, people belong to male or female, literacy level of the people, health condition of the people, occupation and income of the people. These all comprise of structure of population, which is very important factor or which is very important composition in a population. If we see that there, if we analyze Bangladesh and Japan, which are very densely populated, but in the economic development, if we compare, we can see that Japan is a very developed country. But even though Bangladesh has lot of people, its development is less compared to Japan. So the development depends upon human resource. People who are the resource in a country, in that the age of the people, literacy level, health condition, income, occupation, all these depend, all this constitute together for the development of the country. Next, if we see the population pyramid, there is a particular particular pyramid or particular structure which shows the population pyramid. Population pyramid in the sense the total population of the country is divided into various age groups. The age groups are, for example, 5 to 9 years children, 10 to 14 years children, like that age groups it is divided. And again the total population again divided, subdivided into males and females in each of those groups. So we can see that this population pyramid is which shows the total population which divided into age and which divided into, which subdivided into male and female. So population pyramid, if we compare of different countries, we could see in different shapes. Population pyramid is of different shape. Let us see, the population pyramid is very broad at the base and narrows towards the top. For example, it is shown in your textbook in figure number 6.7, which is the population pyramid of Kenya. Population pyramid of Kenya shows which is broad at the base, narrower at the end or at the top. Here we can see that it shows both birth rate and death rates are high. So here both birth rate and death rate are high. And also we can see that in the figure 6.7, although many children are born, large percentage of them die at their infancy, means infant mortality rate. So children die at the initial stages, and very few children who become the adult. And at the very early childhood, the children die. Very few children, they become the adult and they become the earning member for the country. Compared to the few, very few people, very few old people, we could see the population pyramid of Kenya in the figure 6.7. Next, we could see, so population pyramid of any country which is broad at the base and narrows towards the top shows that both birth rate and death rate is high. Means mainly we can see childbirth is more. Very few children becomes the adult. That is the trend of this type of population pyramid. Next type of population pyramid, if we see, that is the pyramid is broad at the younger ages age group. In your textbook, it is given in the page number in the 6.8, where we can see the country like India. For example, it is the country like India, where death rate especially among the very young people, it is decreasing. Then the population pyramid is broad at the in the younger age group, or population pyramid is broad in the younger age group, because more infants they become the adult. Means at the base it is population pyramid is broad at the younger age group, shows that most of the infants they become the younger, they become the adults. So this shows that more infants survive to the adulthood, and it is especially in the in India like country, it this is the trend of the population pyramid. It is shown in the figure 6.8. Such a population pyramid or such population contain large number of young people. That means the country has more labor force. Means young people, they are the working age people, and infants and old age people are the dependent groups. So here we can see young people are independent because they are the working force, or they are the working people, and both children or children and age old people, they are dependent people, or they are dependent in the population. If the country has more aged people and infants or children, it means the country it is very difficult for the country to get faster development. If the country has more young people, it means independent people, the economic development can be easily possible. So India like country, we have younger population is more. That means population pyramid at the younger base or younger age, it is broad. Now let us see that the population pyramid of Japan. If we take population pyramid of Japan, we could see narrow at the base. Narrow at the base means low birth rate. Low birth rate, and those who are the people in Japan, decreased death rate and less birth rate. So that is decreased birth rate and less birth rate, which shows in Japan in figure 6.9. It shows that it allow all members of the people to reach to the old age. So Japan is a country where low birth rate and low death rate. So we could see that in the figure 6.9, which is given in your textbook, population pyramid of Japan, which shows very narrow at the base. We could see that in a country, skilled, educated and spirited young people, they become the future of any country or any nation. So skilled, educated and spirited young people, they become the human resource for the entire nation. This is the thing that we have studied in this lesson. So in this lesson we have studied about population pyramid, then we have studied about population composition, which means that the number of people who are dependent and independent. And if independent group is more, that means the country can progress. If dependent group, for example, children and also age old people are more, the country cannot get a faster development. So this we have studied through this population composition. And we could see that this study of population is very important for the development, to analyze the development of a country. So when we analyze the development, population is one of the important factor to study. And any country which has educated, skilled and spirited people, then the country can be productive, or that country can be developed.